Hello everybody, it's DAB, and welcome back to the, well, I'm hoping the finale of the Metal Gear Solid LP. Joined once again with Brian.
What's up?
We have 10 minutes to escape this place, and then she sets off a goddamn alert.
Yeah, so I'm reading an article right now.
Please don't kill me, please don't kill me.
About Brock, start the Jeep!
We need this. No, don't hit me. Get in. Meryl, for fuck's sake!
Fuck you, guard.
I got you had gun. To make me take that first hit. Okay.
Yeah, you gotta shoot everyone, remember? That's what's so terrible about this.
Okay.
Women drivers. Am I right? But no, it explains like where the Joker was in Dark Knight Rises. He is the sole resident in a new Arkham Asylum.
By the way, I'm just going to say, I'm probably going to fail this a couple times.
Yeah, because this second is just garbage. Like, in an otherwise pretty good game, this thing sucks.
What did I just do, bitch?
There's smoke that way! I'm afraid of it!
Oh, this is the only part in the game I can shoot in first person. I would have been doing that the whole time otherwise.
I did this whole thing in third person when I played this game.
Really?
It's horrid. I didn't know you could be in fucking first person.
Well, I knew I could aim, I just... Will you please die?
Guards don't die from bullets. Also, you get tremendous knockback. I also...
Wow, yeah, I'm gonna fucking fail this one.
Yeah. I definitely got established in, not established, but... I got some, or heard some of the most encouraging stuff for people who want to make their own YouTube stuff the other day.
Oh, yeah, please do.
At the end of the day, remember, there are some people who think that Back to the Future is garbage.
Oh, fuck them.
Exactly. They're completely wrong.
This is the most uncomfortable way I've ever held a PlayStation controller before.
Yeah, because you're holding it like you're fucking Voidbird. But you're kind of pushing his shit in. Because usually he's started shooting you by now.
Well, yeah, he can. I'm shooting him.
Ah! Come on, brother! We're going to go find our old raptor, Blue! Spoilers, he lives.
She.
Whatever.
All the dinosaur girls, you know that.
Yeah, that didn't stop them in the first movie, not did it.
No, I think they clear that up with this one, where they're like, you know, they didn't use that same toad DNA. Though, did you like how in Jurassic World they finally covered that, why the raptors don't have feathers and stuff?
I guess.
They did outright say, it's like, well, you know, we had to do it this way, otherwise... Oh, you're a dick.
Eat a dick, brother. You might actually make this. Because it's not...
Okay, this is kind of pissing me off. I'm shooting him.
You're not shooting him hard enough. Ow! Ow! Ow!
Okay, this is also stupid. It's like, how many bullets do you have to fucking take before you wreck your car?
It's fucking liquid. Dude, survived a helicopter crash, a fucking robot exploding, and then being punched off of that robot.
Okay, we made
wow.
it.
Wow! We actually did that on the first try.
Oh, you have no idea how good that feels. I did not want to go through that again. Mainly just because of the guards part. Fuck that part.
Yeah, that's...
Dude, I wouldn't have even, like, been to half health by the time I got to liquid if I'd known I could shoot in first person.
You know, it's pretty bad. We made everything else sound, like, super easy. Yeah, the part we always built up was like, this part sucks dick.
I don't know why I couldn't beat Liquid in the fist fight. When you left last time, I did a little test run and I beat him on my second try.
Yeah. I think it's just because you had to concentrate a little bit for it.
Yeah. I mean, I wasn't really talking to YouTube when I was...
I mean, it's light, medium, it's a Maki Senpuk, and Shoryuken.
You ever love how that's the one thing? They still call it the Shoryuken, they still call it the Hadouken, but they always call it the Hurricane Kick, because, like, no one's gonna know how to say, Tatsumaki Senpuk, yuck.
No, I'm fine with that.
They don't call it the Rising Dragon Punch. They don't... What?
Snake! Yeah.
Excuse me one second. I can't pause, so...
Don't worry. AIDS is about to happen. Wow, you lovely folks today. Hope you're feeling splendid. I know I am. You're finally getting this done. That lovely blonde mullet going in. Yeah. You know, I'm really kind of curious. Like, I know the building's over there, but what is that echo coming from, huh? Tell us, Liquid. Before you go to your last words. Well, McDonald Miller died.
No, not McDonald Miller. Huh. Well, now my whole family's dead.
Hooray! Only child! Only child! Best Christmas ever!
It.
What happened to the air raid? No stealth bombers in sight.
Well, air raid's a pretty expensive game, Snake. There was only like, God, 10 copies ever made.
Is that the one for 2600?
Yeah.
Are you okay? Colonel, what happened? The Secretary of Defense has been arrested.
This was like, I had it for 30 seconds, and then I fucking sold it.
Well, that's what I said. If I ever find an NES great card, NES World Championship great card, it's mine. If I find a gold card, I take a picture for posterity, and then I put that bitch on eBay.
I'd put it up to auction. You go to third place in that. eBay is not going to be the best place to try. You're definitely going to get a bunch of fake bids.
Yeah, that's true. Once again, I have
complete authority over this. Buy now, $30,000.
I see.
Yeah. Washington isn't stupid enough to use nukes to come. There was a brief time when the only known copy of Tetris on Genesis, like the legit one that they made, I think Tengen made it.
Yeah.
They only got the one copy out. Or there was a few, but they all got recalled, just one made it out. Someone had it up on eBay for $1 million factory sealed. It never sold.
Suck my dick.
But I mean, it is a one of a kind video game. In a sense. I mean, it's not like every system doesn't have a Tetris.
Yeah, I know. But there are probably people who make repo cards that, oh, this is a one-of-a-kind game. I've got a present for you. Someone can make a repo card of a Tetris or the Genesis.
I have
this
it.
This is a one-of-a-kind game.
Say, I have the repro card.
Yeah. Is that, did they put the Tengen thing on there, too?
I don't think it says Tengen.
Okay. I'm really starting to like repo cards. I don't know why. They're just
I know, I finally, interesting. I get Mother, and then it finally gets released in English.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, super psyched about it still.
Have you touched it?
I played it a little tiny bit.
Not as good as Earthbound?
Well, I mean, it's a late 80s, early 90s RPG. It's super cryptic.
Okay.
It is one of those games that now you could not play without a guide, no matter what anybody says. There's so much shit you wouldn't know unless you just knew.
There's so many modern gaming conventions now that it's just out there. I've got that, you, me, and Mei-Ling will be. I don't know. I've tried playing Earthbound. I honestly think it comes down to the combat system not being expressive enough for me.
I mean,
I have a hard time getting into it.
Yeah, that's what a lot of people said. It was modeled after Dragon Quest. Tell me one thing. But it's like they were slapping a fresh coat of paint on, at the time, a 12-year-old battle system with Earthbound.
Yeah. It killed Liquid. Naomi said that she would talk to you face to face. Mother 3 has that whole music thing, that is
which
like,
is really fucking hard to do.
Yeah, I was not interested in that. Snake, it's me.
Naomi. I love this.
Your brother died.
I'm sorry. But he had one last message he wanted to say to you.
No, he didn't. Did he really? The way he hid my pony for Christmas. Your own life. Frankie said that?
Yeah. He also said he'll always love you.
Frankie Yeager. It sounds like Foster's home with fucking alcohol. You,
wait, what?
Frankie Yeager?
Oh, yeah. He fought with every ounce of strength in his body.
Maybe now he's finally found some peace. So, Mega Man 2 is super fun. Really my brother
anymore. Well, I've done a Let's Play of Mega Man, and by the time this is up, Mega Man will be up, so Mega Man 2 is not in the too far away.
Good, Mega Man 2 is the best. Yeah, you can be a hater, it's the best.
Oh, the classics, maybe. You don't even have the slide, though.
So?
The slide is super fun.
The slide does not come in handy as much as everyone puts it up.
But
it
adds,
four or five.
It can add way more level variety. What do you mean?
I guess.
But plus, I don't know, man. Classic series. I think my favorite's probably 9.
9 is not in the classic series.
It's considered a classic Mega Man game.
I don't care. It's a fucking... I do not consider 9 or 10 to be part of the classic series when it was like Capcom decide, oh shit, Mega Man still sells? Alright, here's 2 retro style Mega Mans. We'll put like 3 people on it for a week. Written into their own genetic code. It's unchangeable, immutable. But that's especially when they decide to downgrade Mega Man.
Because they put him back to the way people like you who love Mega Man 2 so much loved him without his charge shot or his slide.
Yeah, and I understand that.
They made it way fucking harder than Mega Man 2.
But, yeah, I'm not saying that that's not the case. But here's the thing. The charge wasn't the problem. Because the Robot Master levels are always easy.
Nah.
Except for Quick Man. We were having a problem with Quick Man last night.
The room's shaped like a funnel.
Yeah, I know. But, there's just one... There's the one part where you actually have to platform through, and we just kept getting stuck there.
Okay, I'm gonna tell you, if you guys could recharge it, you could use the time stopper.
Oh, you can, because you get a checkpoint right before there.
Oh, and you wouldn't be able to recharge
it? Yeah, I'm not talking about the beginning part of the level where it's a funnel. I'm talking about the part where it's, like, 4 screens in a row.
Yeah.
But there's... If you fall a certain place, you're basically fucked.
Yeah.
And,
usually because you were trying to get something you shouldn't have been trying to get.
Yeah, we weren't, and we were still getting fucked, and I realized this morning, because last night, you know, I was off of a 12-hour shift, and then, you know, 4 hours later, I'm usually in bed.
Yeah.
But
nope, recording Mega Man 2.
Yeah, that, I can't go as far away from the ledges as I need, or as I wanted to.
Oh, no, you gotta hug that shit.
Yeah. And that was the issue. I was like,
because it's one of those things that
fucking duh.
Even if you're playing it on American normal, like, it doesn't change.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, we were just doing American normal because I wasn't playing most of it. Exist to pass down our hopes and dreams of the future through our children. I just the guy I
Snowmobile.
Stream with has never played Mega Man 2. I was like,
he has missed out on life.
Awesome. Yeah, no. Mega Man 2 has my favorite music. It has the best weapon ever. Which is actually almost broken.
Oh, dude, especially in American Normal.
Yeah, the Metal Blade is...
I think it uses even less weapon energy.
Oh, wow. Bar none, the best weapon. But, I don't know, I did that game for the most part, except for, like, the final boss, which you have to use the bubble lead on.
Yeah.
I've done that... I did a whole Buster run with that.
Infinite ammo. Of what? That's like the only part of Metal Gear Solid 2 I really love.
What?
When it's like, you're running through this final hallway with Snake, and Raiden's like, are you gonna have enough ammunition to get through? Absolutely. And he points at his headband, infinite ammo.
What?
It's the best part of that game.
I'm just like, running like, what?
Yeah.
No. You come back here and fucking explain this.
So that thing on your head... makes it so you don't run out of bullets.
Yeah, but I still shoot blanks. Maybe it's written into my genes. You're sterile.
Sterile Snake. I'm also with a friend of ours, Warren, how in Metal Gear Solid 4 it would have been funnier if he was called Flaccid Snake.
Someone else? Well, if we have to come up with cool, edgy names like Venom Snake.
No, that's middle-aged Big Boss. I'm talking like 70-year-old Solid Snake in MGS4.
I know. He You age.
Yeah, I thought Venom horrible. Snake was stupid. At least in, like, Portable Ops and Peace Walker, he was just Snake.
David. Yeah. My name's
David. David. Okay. So where to, Dave?
I want chicken wings. Let's go to Hooters. A new path in life. A new path? But we can find a much better wing place. Nope, Hooters it is. Do you realize she's going to freeze to death, Snake? You're in Alaska and she's got a fucking vest on.
I just want to throw this out there, timing in with what you said. It's like, we're going to Hooters. I know we'll find it. And he's like revving the engine. Yeah.
Spring brings new life to everything. A cuddly little caribou. I've lived here a long time. But Alaska has never looked more beautiful. Sky.
I will say, I actually looked really good throughout this game until right around the time we got to Rex, and then I really started sucking it up.
Yeah.
Probably because that's when we had taken our break. It's like, I had torn through this game in like 2 days.
Oh, Meryl. Your hair looks like Monera. Monera. Enjoy life. Yeah, Monera covered spaghetti. I don't know why I was...
Marinara?
Yeah, that's like... No, I was like, that right? No,
how many eras are in this song? This is a word.
Era.
The word marinara, coined by the Beastie Boys.
Oh, wow, you're right. I miss the Beastie Boys. In the 1980s, hair metal became a thing, and everyone was happy. Yeah.
Yep, and I am going to cut the audio so the rest of you can enjoy the amazing ending theme of this game. The best is yet to come. So thanks for watching, everybody. Until next time.
Bye-bye!
Thank you. You mustn't allow yourself to be chained to fate, to be ruled by your genes. Humans can choose the type of life they want to live. The important thing is that you choose life, and then live.
Yes, sir. The entire unit was wiped out. Those two are still alive. The Vector? Yes, sir. Fox Dye should become activated soon, right on schedule. Yes, sir, I recovered all of Rex's dummy warhead data. No, sir, my cover is intact. Nobody knows who I really am. Yes, the DARPA chief knew my identity, but he's been disposed of. Yes. The inferior one was the winner after all. That's right. Until the very end, Liquid thought he was the inferior one. Yes, sir, I agree completely. It takes a well-balanced individual such as yourself to rule the world. No, sir. No one knows that you were the third one, Solidus. What should I do about the woman? Yes, sir. I'll keep her under surveillance. Yes. Thank you. Goodbye, Mr. President.